Don't leave me. I just wanted to introduce you. So we can start? Okay. So, hello everybody. Welcome to the Debian Medbuff. It's quite typical that we are just a few people because it's kind of a niche topic. And so I'm also standing here in the middle of this room and not on top of this booth to be a little bit closer to you. So for the very short introduction, I want to give some overview about the history. The idea was born at Libre Software meeting. You see a lot of Bordeaux wine bottles there. It was of Libre Software meeting 2001. We had some idea, and after having some wine, we started coding. Actually, we were preparing a talk. This is no fake, because the idea was born. I had a talk in the next day on some medical history, on medical open source track. So how developed this team? I'm entertained to make some statistics about people who are working with our team. And these are actually the upload statistics of packages which are maintained by the Debian Med team. You see, in the first 3-4 years, not so much happened. It was basically about some microbiology software which is also used in medicine. And then we, from 2006, 2007, you see some steep slope, and we have actually gathered a lot of people and a lot of packages which are maintained by the Debian Med team, and I think this is something we can be proud about. In comparison, this is the chatter on the mailing list, what we are chatting about. So it's no point in that I'm the most active writer on the mailing list. I'm actually even more proud on the people we got in the last 5 years about. You see there is a solid base of people discussing issues. We are not really losing a lot of people. Some or two went over to other projects a bit, but we are about 15 to 20 people who regularly are discussing on the Debian Med mailing list. And we have also some more developer-oriented lists started in 2006, which is also featuring some interesting discussions, and so you see the project is somehow healthy, and it's not entertained only just for the fun of one or two people, which is the case, or it might be the case in such a niche project. And I always say, medicine and free software has a very, very small common set, because typically medical stuff has some money and doesn't care about free software or whatever, and just buys somebody who will care for his software. And so we have to find hardly to get some more users. These are the commits which are done by the Debian Med team. You see, even I'm not winning this anymore, the Charles Plessy is a very, very active developer. He's a biological expert, he's a French and works in Japan. I have never met him, but it's really cool to work together with him. And I think this is quite a good sign that we are a strong team, that we are a lot of people here working. What about the packages? As I told you in the beginning, in 2002, there was something which I just have picked up from other developers who dropped some microbiology packages, and we had some packages for imaging, which might be also used by medical care. So, and you see a large increase of microbiology software. This is quite typical because this biological software is basically invented and written in universities. And universities tend to have much more free software than in other places of medical care. And so we have this lot of microbiology software. It's also could be used in my institute. I'm also working in the medical institute, which is investigating several things, but specifically where I'm living, they are sequencing stuff, and so this software could be used, but isn't. So for whatever reason. And you also see that there was an increase in the number of packages which are relevant for medical imaging. These are DICOM viewers and so on. And I'm really proud because we have gathered because the DebianMed team exists, we were able to gather developers who are working on this. I'm pretty sure that this software would not be in Debian if the DebianMed project wouldn't exist. And so you see some medical imaging software which is increasing more and more. We just got two other packages which were very famous and helpful. And you also see a small bar starting from 2005 with medical practice programs. So this is also a problem I want to address with this graph. If people hear DebianMed, they assume this would be some DVD or live DVD they could throw in their computer in their medical practice and can manage the practice. And this is just wrong. And it will probably be wrong for all the time, because I want my doctor to cure me and not his computer. So I would always suggest to have some service company who does the service for the doctor, and I want to have to hand over DebianMed to this company. And I care for the computer of the doctor, and I want to do the preparation of this company, and they could base their service on free software, which I think is a very good idea. And then in that way, by this proxy, DebianMed could make it into a medical practice. These practice management programs are programmed and also used by doctors, which are at the same time programmers. They have not that much users, but they have some. And I think it's quite of promising. We had I could serve you with a long list of free software which claims to be able to manage a medical practice. But if you look at the code and look at the organization of the project also, they are mostly not. And there is one good example, which is called GnuMed. We have included it, and we might get some others of it. But you have to be careful if you see free medical software. It's frequently some stuff a doctor sat down in the evening and write some code and also learn some tickle programming and starts coding, and it's not useful for anybody else. So please be careful, and we hope to pick the cherries out of this with the DebianMed project. And if you know some such cherries we should include, just talk to us and write to our mailing list, and we will include it in our kind of to-do list. So far for the statistics, what tasks are we covering in DebianMed? As I said, we have molecular biology, structural biology, and bioinformatics, and we have even some separate so-called tasks for if you want to develop medical applications. We have a set of next generation sequencing programs, and I tend to say we cover all important free software which is available there, because these people are quite active. This is also Charles Plessy and Stefan Möller who are behind this. We have some packages where you can do some phylogeny, and we have also made some, it's just picking out of all the software which is called cloud computing, which you can run on a Xterm and which doesn't need any graphic interface. So this is the biology part. This is quite good covered. We have a drug database which is used in medical practice programs, which is quite new and I hope useful. I'm no doctor, I can't tell about, but these doctors who are using GnuMed are keen on it and they like it. We have some epidemiology software, and this is also quite good stuff. It's most of these packages are using GNU-R, the statistic package, and
is useful for epidemiologists. As I said, we have a lot of medical imaging programs and TICOM viewers. We have a quite strong team behind it. We have some medical physics packages. We have, as I said, medical practice. And we have some about psychological research. It is a NeuroDebian project, which is run more or less by two Debian developers, which are very active. This is a really cool project. It is could be even be a separate project in parallel to Debian Made, because they are doing a lot of stuff and really good work. We have something for statistics and some small tools which are useful for your personal health. And we have something out of tech for if you want to do some publishing, but that's not so much. So we have some tasks we don't cover currently, or we do not yet cover anymore. The good news is that about oncology, we will upload next month. It was just uploaded. There was some issues with the license, which are fixed. It just needs to do 30 minutes of work. I will do it in the next couple of days. We had some content management system inside Debian, which was based on SOAP and SOAP 2. And SOAP 2 was removed from Debian, and so we cannot support this anymore. This is not really a problem, because the SOAP people said, well, perhaps it's not so good to have it packaged anyway, and you can easily install it. So we can recommend people who want to run this on their computer, and it's quite easy to install. So it's not something we really lost for the users, but it's not packaged anymore. We had once a program which was intended to manage a dental practice, which was actually written by a dentist, which was accidentally a Debian developer, but he just stopped his work on it, and so it was finally removed from Debian, because it was somehow orphaned, and you can't be sure if it works, and you cannot provide something honestly to people who depend on it if it's not maintained anymore. A little harder point is our hospital information systems, because these systems are quite complex, and we are working on one thing which has some coverage in the United States and other countries, which is called VISTA. It needs a special database system which is called MUMS, GTM MUMS, and we are currently strongly working on this. It's a kind of nice experience for me, because we just got a Debian developer who said, hey, Debian Made, it's a cool team. I have no relation to medical stuff, but I would like to help you. And he started working on this MUMS, where we have no manpower. And he has some free time slots and is currently working on it. I'm really happy, because I never started attacking this beast. It's really hard. You need to bootstrap it. You need to have a running MUMS database to get it compiled the next version, so kind of GCC stuff. And hopefully we will get it for the next Debian release. But I'm optimistic, but I can't promise anything. There is some software where you can maintain a medical laboratory, but we have not yet started working on this, so we can just recommend it. If there is somebody outside who wants to do it, that's fine. Just stay in contact with us, and we can help you when it's about maintaining some package in Debian. It's the same with pharmacy. It tends a little bit into direction chemistry. So our goal in Debian Made is, because while we are 10 to 15 people, we cannot do everything ourselves. Our goal is to invite even more people to join us, to prepare or to teach people how to prepare Debian packages, and sponsor these packages to the Debian pool. This worked quite good in the case of so-called BioLinux. BioLinux is more or less biological distribution. It was formerly based on Debian, now in Ubuntu for whatever reason. And these people were doing the following. They have a common set of applications to Debian Mate, but they didn't use the Debian Mate packages, but rebuilt the packages in a non-conformant way. They moved all the packages to user local, which is not a good idea in my opinion, and added other software which we don't have, instead of saying, hey, I could join Debian Mate team, put these packages inside Debian and use what we are preparing. These were three people basically working in Great Britain at the Sanger Institute, such a large institute. And now they had to learn that people go away and this is only one was remaining and said, hey, if I don't join the Debian Mate team, I will not make it. And so he finally joined and yeah, we have now some kind of cooperation and I really hope that they will base their work on ours. They could label their stuff Debian, BioLinux or whatever. They could do whatever, it's free. But fixing the problem is the root, so putting everything in Debian and then derive later is, in my opinion, the way you could make your work very, very easy. So this is, these are the people who probably entered Debian via Debian Mate. What is my opinion, what we as a Debian Mate team can bring back to Debian, because we just have this list of several people who more or less are Debian developers or Debian maintainers because this team exists. They just entered Debian Mate, did some work, and then decided, oh, I could do some work in this team. The microphone, there's a question. Yeah, always feel free to interrupt me. If the mic works, then switch is on. You have to press a little bit longer.
Andreas, what is the professional background of the team members? Yeah. Are these all medical doctors or researchers?
The first four people are biologists. The fifth, David Palaino, is a student of oncology, as a dentist or want to become a dentist. He is very, very, very busy inside Debian, and he even left the Debian Mate project to do some other stuff. So this is a dentist, Tobias Quarthammer. I'm not really sure. I think he is a doctor, and he is caring a lot for documentation. Michael Hanke is part of the NeuroDebian team, so he's a neurologist. Jürgen Salk, Dominik Behashemi, Mathieu Malater are professionals in medical imaging. And Alex Metashvili is also a biologist. So they are basically medical experts in the wider sense, in contrast to me. And I really rely on these people because I'm a physicist and I need to know this expertise. So I'm very happy that these people are inside. And I would even invite any biologist or whatever, even if you have no programming skills, to join the project and help us evaluating the software, which is also a very, very valuable thing. So on. And we have also here in the room Michael and Vanessa, who also came of part of the team, but I don't think they are in Debian because it's Debian Mate exists. You are there anyway. So we have more on the team, but these people came to Debian because the team existed. This was the end of this slide. So now I'm coming to some stuff we are doing, in my opinion, not so good. It is, as I said, free software and medicine have a small common set of people, but we could do better to make the project more visible. I was hesitating in the first period, the first 5 years, to advertise Debian Mate so much because, we had not so much. And if you advertise something to the world, hey, we are great, whatever, and they look and there is not much, they will never come back. But I think now we are in a state where we have something we can present, and we have some use cases, even if
people might have the wrong expectation, as I said. Well, I would want to write like my medical practice with this. And it is just wrong to say that we can cover everything. We cannot manage billing and so, which is not included in the software, and doctors want to do billing. And there is some software, it's not included, it's not compatible with everything, so there's work in progress, and we should mention this all the time, but we can do some better with. For instance, we now have a Debian made block, which is cool. I have also to admit, maybe I'm too old. I'm not in all this Twitter, blogging, Facebook stuff. I need help. I need help from young people who are doing this. I'm reading on the mailing list. This is more or less everything I'm doing for communication, or email is my main means of communication. And I can't do everything. You see, I'm posting quite frequently. I have a fixed times. It's always my spare time. I can do the work. And if I split this time, I have to drop other things like building packages and so. So just, I need your help. Vanessa was quite good in creating Twitter and Identica and Facebook accounts. If you want to comment now or raise your hand or later, or you have any ideas, just cry for the microphone.
Yes, I created a Twitter and Identica account. We don't have a Facebook page yet, but we can have it. So for both cases, Twitter and Identica, the user is DebianMed. And please join and share your comments with us via social networks. Right now, I'm trying to make a script that takes the information from the DebianMed blog, so those accounts keep more active and post information automatically, so users are up to date and things like that. Also, there was an idea that we can take information from package uploads and new packages in the DebianMed project to be posted on those accounts too. I think that would be nice. There was a little bit of discussion when this topic went to the mailing list. So since I really like social networks and I think it's a really good idea and a way to get new users and maybe get more people interested in the project, I said, okay, I'll do it. I like this way of communicating, and I have I didn't have the time at the moment, but now I have the time to work on it, so I just took charge of it. So.
Yeah, thank you. So it could be a way to I don't know this interface, but if a package is uploaded of the DebianMed team, it goes a mail to the mailing list, and we could use this to trigger this to forward this package is uploaded to Debian a new version and tweet about this, and perhaps with a short description or so. This should be probably possible, and to just create some traffic to make people aware that there is something, that something is happening. We have also an IRC channel, and I tend to use an IRC channels if I'm on DebConf and not else. And I think there was any posting over DebConf on this channel. So it is silent there. If people prefer IRC, just try it if it helps. And if you think about other means of communication, I'm open for any suggestions. And we should also be more visible inside the world. Visibility means we really need a logo. We have some competing logos somehow. One we actually can't not really use because it is using the Red Cross, which you can't use. It is copyrighted and so. This is not possible, but currently nobody cared. And we have a different one with a snake around something. So if you know a good designer and we decided about the logo, I'm not so keen on deciding about this stuff. I'm more technical, and if people say, well, this is a good one, we should probably do it. If you have also inside Debian, Valesio is doing a lot of stuff about painting images and multimedia. Perhaps we can ask him for help to make the single and good logo, whatever. We can do it. And we perhaps need to have a flyer. I once made some such thing. It is in a repository based on Tech with this two-side A4 thing, which is translated on one side in English and one in German, and it is perfectly outdated and should be adapted to the new things. And so this is something we actually also need, and we probably need a lot of more stuff to make us more visible.
Also work with
the mic?
And I'm from Linux Magazine as a journalist. Please work with the Debian Press team, because
yes.
I'm on their list. So your channel or any team's channel to the press.
Yeah, this is right. I realized this one. You always have to decide when it's time to say, well, we read something. This was interesting because there was some noise on German news channels about OpenSUSE Medical, which is kind of a friendly or parallel project. It has also Fedora Med, and they regularly issue new releases about OpenSUSE Medical. We in Debian Med have the following problem. We release if Debian releases, because we are inside Debian. So there is no actual Debian Med release, because we are no separate project. And that's why we can't issue these, hey, Debian Med release stuff. You want to say something?
You could have a stable PPA once PPAs are available.
Mm-hmm.
You could have a stable PPA for Debian Med and then release more often.
Yeah, we could think about this. Yes, this is right.
And the press release 2 weeks before Debian.
Yeah. Okay. So could somebody note these ideas in the Gobi document, please? This would be great.
About these Java applications?
Yes.
Try to exclude the Java from Debian Med?
Well, the problem is we have a lot of interesting Java application we would like to include in Debian, but you have always a problem that upstream provides a large tabel or Java or whatever, which includes 10, 50, whatever.
Yes, I don't like Java.
Well, it's not about I like it. It
because
makes it hard. Yeah, it just makes it hard to package, because in Debian you have to provide the source for everything, and you should not add different versions of libraries. And so we always have to, if we want to have one Java application, we need to package about, say, 10 other libraries to get this in. Otherwise, it goes to non-free because there's no code. This is really hard. Yeah. Do you have a comment?
There's a question on IRC. Does Debian Med offer only a software solution? Is there a complete solution with hardware and consulting service contracts or third-party companies? That's from Dilex.
No, there isn't, but it would be cool to have. Not yet. So, yeah, this is, in the beginning I said this is some kind of my plan to provide to a company. We are not there, but I could imagine that it's perfectly possible if there would be a company interested in doing so. I would really love that. So, yeah, back to the Java application. So I managed to get 103 package that way, but I could work 1 year full time to get all the interesting stuff in Debian, but I have no time to do it full time. I have only my spare time, and I have also to do other things for them. And so this is hard. If we have some Java competence, just join us. And there is large applications like Vista. I mentioned this in the beginning. It is a hospital management system. So we are currently proceeding a little bit in this, but this is also, there are large applications. The hospital management of a large hospital is a hard thing. It's like the question was a little bit touching. And you could probably earn a lot of money with a company which is running this stuff based on Debian Med in some hospital, because you can ask for a lot of money in a hospital if you do it reliable. And we could make your job as a company easier than you would have it if you would have to build everything on your own. This is what we can provide on Debian Med. Yeah, we have also to work out some non-free issues, because, well, in the pure technical world where people are quite in the coding, you just learned about what means the difference between free and non-free. But the software is quite frequently written by not so technical expert. It is written by biologists, and they apply licenses like, well, you can use it for free in for educational and scientific use, but if you want to put it in some device, I would like to have $1. So, okay, I can understand this license. It's okay. But this software cannot be put on a Debian DVD, because we would to deliver $1 per Debian DVD to this person. But it's just not possible, because people will not use this specific software. And so it's a problem with this license, and we try to teach authors about this. And sometimes we were successful and sometimes not. So you can always work on this issue. So if you have no coding abilities, writing nice emails about licenses to authors also fine thing. Do we have install or live CDs or something like this? No, we don't have at the moment. Because my idea is that if you install Debian and install the meta package we are providing, it's quite simple to install, and it works for the user base we have currently. This might change in the future, and so we might build install CDs, but I want to do something in advance. For instance, there was a very interesting buff 2 days ago, which said package recommender, and I would like to have some investigation in all these people who are here have installed our medical packages. What are they using? Are they tending to use a certain desktop browser or whatever? And I would like to put this stuff, which has proven to be useful for these people, to put on this CD. What about a live CD? I think you can build a live CD quite easily. We have the meta packages. Just use Live Helper and put them on the live CD.
Yeah, you just have to maintain the task.
Yes, we maintain meta packages and tasks. They are created automatically, and this is quite easy to build a live CD. So we do not provide any specific support for it. That's the reason.
But you could ask it for it to be built regularly.
Yes. Yeah, we have a to-do list in the wiki. There's a link. The link is also in the Gobi document, and it is separated into a to-do list for users with not so much coding skills and packagers. So you probably will be able to pick a job which fits your skills. And you also find a list of bugs. We are using the Blends techniques. The Blends techniques provide task pages with an overview of what we have, and they are also providing the so-called bugs pages. There the bugs are put in categories like biology, medical practice, and whatever. And if you are interested in a certain field, just go to this bugs page and pick your bug of choice and fix it. It's easy. And it's basically what I wanted to tell you. So we have 10 minutes left. If we can fill this 10 minutes with questions, it's fine. If not, I can do some, can show you something on the tasks or bugs pages, whatever. So, just go on.
I don't want to take up too much of your time because it's your buff, but what are the plans for the next Debian release? Is there anything that you want to have in Debian Med by, what's it called?
Wheezy.
Yeah,
but for the first remark, you don't steal time, you are a member of the buff, so it's fine if you ask. And the plan is to have this Vista inside, or at least GTM MUMS, which is a precondition for Vista, because of this bootstrapping process is quite of a technical work. We would like to have two other practice management systems, which are, one is based in France and quite adapted to the French medical system, and the other one is called FreeMade. It is a PHP, so it's a browser-driven system. There are doctors out there who don't want to use such stuff. Others want to use it. So these are those system I would consider serious. We also like to have some of these Java packages included, which are some applications which are frequently used by biologists. And this is basically what we want to include. We should perhaps also put this on the wiki page, some kind of release goals. Yes, thank you.
Are there any programs for machines or something? I mean, like for MRI or something that is free?
I'm not really sure. There is in the oncology field, there is something what you are using to build models how to prepare the radiation and to put it in the right place. And so there is a free program called PRISM. It is written in Lisp, and we had contact 6 years ago to the main author, and then he forgot. And now he came back and said, oh, this was something interesting. I found an old mail. Would you like to include it? But we now need a Lisp expert in the DebianMed team. And this seems to be complex, but it would be also interesting to have this included until Wheezy is released. It is possible, but we might miss this goal. So this Thorsten Alterhotz, who is working on this MUMS thingy, get also engaged in Lisp, because I said, oh, I don't know, this seems to be interesting, I would like to do this. And so it's really cool, because we got some help out of nowhere, which is really appreciated, and perhaps it works out. So any other questions? No? Yeah, the mic? No, please wait for the mic.
You could put the Lisp problem to a Lisp mailing list.
Yeah, sure. We do so.
Some people like, yes, a challenge.
Yeah. So we are communicating with the Lisp mailing list, and we are communicating with the Java mailing list. I'm also joined the Java buff tomorrow. So we are just talking with other teams inside Debian. That's what we actually are doing. But the hint is perfectly good. What? Please, can you?
You could try a general
not the Debian
mailing list.
Yeah.
But go outside Debian.
Outside Debian?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I'm afraid of this. Yeah, but yeah, good hint. Yeah, thank you. So, well, perhaps I can show something. We have here Debian Med. This is, there's another question. A question from the video team.
Hi. Well, it's not actually a question. It was just an idea for a logo. You could have a scalpel slashing a swirl into some flesh.
Yeah. Any idea about the logo?
I'm not an artist, though.
Yeah. So you see, this is one version, which is not good. We should replace this more or less. And this is actually the example it's generated from this task techniques inside the Blend framework. Here you can see easily what task needs some work. The red ones are obviously those which are in need of work. Medical data, we have only one drug database, and this is bug-free, so there are no bugs, and we have several bugs in imaging system, so we can use one. But it's not looking that bad as it might seem here. There are also some more generic packages inside. So this ANS is somehow connected to our, this is a neuroimaging, this is a neuroDebian package which has a problem. But for instance, there are problems in, basically the neuroimaging which has to fight through their bugs, and some of them are all DCOM. ImageJ is more a general package, but yes, here you can see what work can be done. Or what about the biology? So where we have more programs, there are more chances for causing trouble. So here we are closely working together with the Debichem team. These people are working on software which is relevant for chemists and for biologists. So you see, if this window would a little bit larger, you would see. One moment. You would see that it's maintained by the Debichem team. So we are working closely together with other blends. So you see, there are some bugs to fix. And if you like this, it's okay. Or if you want to advertise Debian Made, what is, in my opinion, the first way you can do, go to our tasks page. And if somebody, I just invented this stuff for the Blend framework to answer the question, what are you doing? It is sometimes really hard for us to tell anybody what I'm doing. And my colleagues, which are interested in biological software, are just happy if they see this page, what they can have. These pages are translated as far as the Debian description is translated. The pages are showing screenshots. Why can't I see it here? So if there is a screenshot of a package, you can see it here.
Is that a screenshot?
From screenshots.debian.net. Yeah, it is. These pages are auto-generated every day. They are using UDD. And I made sure that the screenshots are in UDD, that the translations are in UDD, DebText was not planned. The new, what's in new is also in UDD drin. So we can go to, actually we have no packages in the new queue because FTP master is that fast the last time. So I was feeding information first to UDD and then I was putting it on these pages. This was the idea. So these pages are more or less for answering the question, what's inside Debian Made? Or other blends. There were two people from Debian AU sitting around and they left us. I don't know why. I would have stick to their session, whatever.
And so, for everyone else, UDD is Ultimate Debian Database?
Ultimate Debian Database, yes. It should keep any information about packages in Debian. And it has at least a lot, and even about Ubuntu. I would will enhance the you have here what versions are inside Debian, and we have currently here, this is an example, only an experimental. We have also other, I will show you. We have just 1 minute left. So you can see what versions of this package called phylib is in Debian, and I would extend this to what's in Ubuntu because it's a frequently asked question, so we have friendly also to Ubuntu. I have no problems with this. So time is up. Thank you very much for attendance. I hope that we were able to win some new people in Debian Meet and have fun for the rest of the DebConf.